Well, we are, all of us, Kathy, okay, Pat, you belong over here, come on, come on, ladies. This is a special award, it's in recognition of exemplary service and dedication to helping those with mental illness. And I can tell you, because this class is full like this every time, and the next time, it's full with a whole bunch of different people. But people have reached out to him and asked him for help Sunday, Saturday, I'm not saying he does this all the time. But he's emailed back, and they go, he called me, it was Sunday, he called me, and I said, well, yes. And he honestly, genuinely cares, and does so much for all of us. I can personally, I can tell you with my son, he kept me abreast, HIPAA's not letting you know anything. Once it goes to the public guardian, a few more doors are open so you can be advised of some things. And he would call, okay, this is gonna happen. And it was just such a relief to know things are going on. So before I give this to you, you have to stand here and bear with us. Debbie, I know you wanna say something.
Yes, I'm so glad to be part of this honor of recognizing someone who really is helping the families. I've been a family support group facilitator for 7 odd years, and it's been more recently that when we call the Department of Mental Health, they help and they give us the answer. They're there behind us. We don't have to feel we're alone fighting, trying to jump over a tall building and leaving bound. And especially when we're trying to get conservatorship or when we're trying to get people to call the families back, we try to open doors that should be open, try to get communication. When we don't have that help, you know, we're getting help from Dr. Shaner. I know so many families are so frustrated because they want to help and they don't get, and no one calls them back. Their loved one's in the hospital, they don't know what's going on. They understand the HIPAA law. They understand the HIPAA law, but they also understand that they should be able to get some information to the hospital. They're not getting that. And then once they're there, you know, if they need to be conserved, if they need AOT, you know, Dr. Shaner and also the Family and Consumer Affairs Division of DMH has been really helpful to the people. I feel like I'm one of the worst offenders of weekly sending people there and giving them the brochure from DMH, but I'm so thankful for all you do, and thank you so much.
We really are. We have to deal with this.
I'm Sherry Assessman. I'm a parent. I was sitting in one of your seats here, another meeting, and I was given all the instructions and wrote all the letters and did what you're instructed to do. And I have to say, at the final hour, towards the end of our 14-day hold, when we were desperate, we weren't going to get conservatorship, we weren't going to get any application, we sent out that email. And I was told, Dr. Shaner, that you were out of town for that day, but not to worry, you would get the information. And within hours, I started getting replies as somebody called from your office to let me know that it was received, they were doing an investigation. And I was very happy and content at that point. But what happened a few hours later, you personally called me and you reassured me, you listened, you understood, and I knew you were there to fight for our daughter. And I just am filled with gratitude for the call. You think it's an impersonal system, it's very large, but no, Dr. Shaner cares, and the people that you work for you, you have transmitted that to others, and they have been really helpful to us. And since August 12th, our daughter is still getting help, and so we have gotten conservatorship. So thank you.
This is an earth angel. Yes. He really is. I just sent him a family yesterday, and I echoed everybody here. Dr. Shaner, you really, after the struggles, the fights, and the families, when they get a call from you, they feel heard, and they continue to fight. So thank you. But really, he's an earth angel.
We hit brick walls. He's got the sledgehammer to.
Yes, he does. And gal, oh my gosh.
Nancy, thank you. And
well, I'm going to say that
Dr. Shaner is kind of, I'll use a household word in our NAMI chapter. He's been extremely supportive of the ventures of NAMI. He's been supportive of our activities. Sometimes it's almost like a board meeting that sometimes it's almost like every board meeting somehow or another your name comes up and we just talk about all of your good works. And I just really am so grateful to be here and thank you so much for everything.
I'm very glad we have you in the department I work for. I know it's an asset and things are better run because of you. So thank you.
Okay, thank you.
You make a difference.
Yes, Dr. Shaner, here I am. You know, I'm always,
I should take
always
mine
following.
Out too.
I'm always following. No, this is video. This is video.
You know, you get in there.
Oh, okay. Well, I here.
I can't even do a selfie, so.
I don't know when you sleep. I mean, do you? Between you and Dr. Sharon, you guys are like heroes to us. You're the ones that are paving the roads for better treatment. Right now, I got a letter from the court that they're looking at me and wondering whether I should be conservator because somebody reported me from family of abuse, and I'm going to need your help after this meeting because it's insane. Because it was the hospital that didn't give my son the treatment that he needed is the one that then did that, because I sent them a long fax letter asking for the, you know, the I'm so sorry, you know, yeah. The administrator's assistant.
We don't need to go into too much detail.
No, but this is like, when we have an emergency, you're there for us, even when you're in Japan. Thank you so much.
Or on the raft, riding the raft. Yes. Then?
I'm sorry. Sorry I'm late. Construction in my house.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, it's just an honor for you always to come and speak to us, but personally, you have helped me, I mean, on the phone, calling the Met team, Clarence is running down the street, the police are there, and we pulled off an intervention. Really. I mean, you just don't have a job, you really make a difference. You make a difference, and you really care. And it's so important because the system is a quagmire, and you're the light in the darkness, so we are so appreciative.
We are honest.
Dr. Shaner.
Oh my gosh, I couldn't have done it without you. And with this lady too. I feel like this is the A-team right here. You guys are amazing. I'm not gonna cry, but our son, I'm now in our second year of the conservatorship. We got the LPS, but it was because of your help, returning all our emails, all our calls. I mean, I just can't appreciate, I mean, we so appreciate you guys. And my husband and I couldn't be here. There's a darn football game he had to watch. But he said, give him a big hug. Anyway, this is from my husband. You guys made a difference, and we could never have done it, gotten this conservatorship without your help. And we're just so appreciative. He's now 6 months into the second year of this conservatorship. He's so much better. He's over 60 pounds overweight because of the medication. So I'm hoping that changes and they find better ones. But
they will.
You have made a difference, and I totally concur with what you had just said. Anyway, thank you.
We should all come up, and we're going to get a picture of you.